Friends, welcome to my channel. Today I'd like to share with you guys some information on food storage and food preservation for the long term and for the short term. Especially right now with COVID, all the stuff that's going on, it's really has me concerned with food shortages and the fact that I live away from home now and all this crazy crap that's going on. So I would just want to share with you guys what I'm doing to help prepare and, like, in a sense, calm myself and reassure myself that we'll be okay in case something does happen where I can't run out to the store. It's important to have a pantry, and it's important to have a place where you can store food, especially like grains, essentials like rice and beans that last forever if you know how to store them properly. So I'm going to show you how to do that today. Right here, I have two, they're stacked up against each other, 3 gallon storage food grade. That's very important that they said food grade storage buckets. And these happen to come with gamma lids. So a gamma lid simply is a lid that if you twist off, becomes airtight when it's closed properly. So this one right here, I'll do a close-up shot, has rubber against the edge. And when you fill the bucket with whatever it is you want in there and you twist it, it creates an airtight seal, which means that no moisture, no mold, no nothing crazy can come into your bucket. If you have, for example, some rice in there, it's free from critters because it's hard plastic. They can't chew through it. For long-term storage, it's also really important to buy Mylar bags. These are what Mylar bags look like. They become airtight once you put a heat source on it. And you know your contents of the bag are gonna be airtight and fairly safe to use at a later time. These are called oxygen absorbers. Oxygen absorbers are also really important here and a must because they suction out any oxygen and things cannot live if there's no air. Here it has these little tab right here, if you could see this little hole, which is used for easy tear. So I'm going to be sealing from the little tear up so that it's airtight, and that's gonna be good for up to 10 years. It sounds insane, but again, with the oxygen absorbers, the Mylar bags, it creates an airtight seal. If you put it in a bucket, it's just another barrier that little critters and things can't get into, and almost becomes waterproof in case you do have some type of flood or water damage. Your items are safe and dry.
So starting off with the short-term storage, I'm going to be emptying out however much fits into this 3-gallon bucket with the gamma lid seal worth of beans. This is going to be for my short-term storage. I'm going to be able to easily get in and out of this bucket because of the awesome airtight seal. So I'm going to be able to have easy access to this whenever I need. The remainder, whatever does not fit in there, is going to go into the marked Mylar bag that I have right next to it. And I like these because it came with a little scooper. So those are out of the way. I have labeled my Mylar bag with the date and the contents of what I'm going to be putting into them. I fill them up, remember, up to the line where it's an easy tear. And right here, I'm adding the oxygen absorbers, which is really important. I'm trying to squeeze out as much air as possible. And I'm going to start by ironing. Be very careful because it does get hot. Ironing the edges first, just to give myself a nice sealant and making sure that the sides are nicely even, so there's not one side longer than the other. I'm gonna start with the corner, and that's gonna be my guide. So very carefully, I'm gonna start sealing the whole bag. Again, I'm gonna go over it a few times, but I do wanna make sure that the edges are nicely sealed, and then very carefully, making sure that everything is even, I go ahead and continue to iron it. I'm on my second bag. It does get a little warm. Again, squeezing out as much air as possible with the oxygen absorbers already in. I'm gonna go ahead and finish this particular bag up and seal it and iron it shut. Once the Mylar bags are sealed, just as a precaution, I go ahead and pat it out, making sure that there are no air bubbles anywhere near there, and I turn it upside down to make sure that nothing is falling out, whether the contents is bean or rice or any other types of grains that you're storing. You gotta make sure that it's airtight. The very last step for long-term storage is to get a 5-gallon or bigger, depending on what you're comfortable with, food grade storage bucket. I have here a 5-gallon, which I'm going to be using to create like the second barrier for my beans and my rice. And as you can see, this is the next day. Look at what the oxygen absorbers did. That is airtight. it even suctioned out the little bit of air that was in there. I go ahead and put my packaged goods in the bucket. Just for safe measures, I add another note with today's date, and with a mallet or with a hammer, seal it closed. That's it, you've created an airtight package, which is your Mylar bag, and then an airtight container, which are these buckets. Put this in a cool, dark, dry place, and you're good to go.
So that's it, friends. I really hope you enjoyed this tutorial. I think it's important that you prepare and you have things readily available. I was caught off guard this first time during quarantine, and I don't ever want to go through that again. And not only am I going to be able to help myself and my family, I can help my neighbors and people who need help if I have a little bit of extra rice and beans, and they can also be used as like a trading option in case I need fresh fruits and veggies or whatnot. So please like my video and subscribe if you haven't already to my channel, and we'll see you guys in the next one.